We all know that we build a dam to hold water back and store it for use in water supply, irrigation, hydropower, or flood control. But sometimes we have to let some water go. That's why every dam needs a spillway to safely discharge water. But what exactly is a spillway, and how does it work? A spillway is a structure constructed in a hydroelectric dam to provide a safe passageway for floodwaters to escape downstream, usually into a river. In the UK, they may be known as overflow channels. Spillways release water so that the water does not overtop and damage or even destroy the dam. As far as infrastructure goes, dams are fairly risky. Depending on the size of the structure and what's downstream, the failure of a dam can be catastrophic. For this reason, they're often required to withstand the biggest storm that we could possibly conceive, called the probable maximum flood. It's too expensive to build a dam so tall that it can store the entirety of this flood. On the other hand, we can't just let the flood overtop the dam, because flowing water can damage and destroy the structure. So in most cases, dams are designed with at least one spillway, a structure that can safely discharge floodwaters without causing injury or deterioration to the dam. Spillways are a crucial part of the dam facility, because once a reservoir has reached capacity, and if floodwaters enter the reservoir, the water level increase could cause overtopping of the dam. When a reservoir is full, its water level will be equal to the height of the spillway. As soon as any excess water enters the reservoir, water will start flowing out through the spillway. It works similar to an overflow hole in a bathtub or sink at home, where if water levels go too high, it'll go into the hole and through the drain. In addition, when there is too much water going through the dam, turbines can't function properly and can be damaged. Spillways protect the dam's elements from being damaged. An emergency spillway is secondary to the principal spillway and is used under extreme conditions in case of a malfunction, such as with the situation at the Lake Oroville Dam. Spillways can be either controlled or uncontrolled, and they function differently depending on their type. Controlled spillways are equipped with gates that can be raised or lowered. Uncontrolled spillways do not have this gate. Regardless of what specific type of spillway is used, they generally consist of a control structure to hold back water, a channel for water to flow through, and a terminal structure.